What's up, guys? Welcome back to the shop. So I did a thing last week, and I ordered a thing, and it's a big thing, and it came in a big box. And I'm gonna be honest with you, this is my first actual plywood palletized box I've ever got. Everything else has been cardboard, so I'm pretty excited about this. What's in the box? So I went ahead and ordered a Amazon special 16 gauge shear press break shear slip roller 3-in-1 machine. It's 58 inches wide. It can do up to 16 gauge metal, which is perfect. I got it for a specific reason, just because the floor we're going to be fabricating for snail mail is going to be made out of 16 gauge steel. So I did pop open the corner of it, one side of it, and flipped it up when the shipping truck showed up, just to make sure it wasn't damaged in shipping, because this corner was kind of bunged up a little bit, but everything was fine. So let's get this thing opened up and see what it looks like. I'm kind of pumped, I'm excited. I'm gonna have to build a stand, unfortunately, but that's all good. Lots of nails, that's gonna hurt. It's gonna be a leg slicer and a half. Well, I definitely packed this thing very well. This is nice. So we finally got our KAKA Industrials slip roller, press brake, and shear set up. I built a stand for it today. I didn't do any recording on it, just kind of threw the thing together. But yeah, there's not a lot of good instructions for this, so I'm not 100% sure that everything's put together and adjusted properly. However, it does shear metal to a knife's edge. This is a little piece we cut. It shears awesome. I have no complaints on the shear. The brake bends pretty good. I need to do a little bit of adjustment to the brake. Over bends a little bit on one side. Let's see here. If you can kind of see that gap there, a little bit tighter on that end. So I need to go ahead and adjust this side up, which I loosen these screws and then loosen that bolt and tighten that up, or vice versa to this side. So in order to dial the brake in perfectly, I need to do that. Underneath here we have the slip roller, and I've played with it a little bit with just some, I don't know what this is, 20 gauge maybe steel, and it works pretty good. We did cut inner fender metal for snail mail, so I think I'm gonna try to slip roll those tonight. One really cool thing about this shear, I gotta show you guys this. The kids were in here and we were messing around earlier, and the paper was in there like that, and I was like, oh yeah, it's like a pair of scissors. It'll cut this paper like a pair of scissors. And nobody believed me, and I didn't think it would cut the piece of paper like that either, but look at that thing. You see that? I don't even know if you can see that. This thing is impressive as fuck. Look at that. It sheared that paper off like it was nothing. Cut it like a pair of scissors. So I'm super impressed with that aspect. The shear so far has been incredibly impressive in the fact that it can cut paper. Just like something that would bend really easy. It's sharp enough and tight enough to cut that. Cut 16 gauge steel, takes a little bit of muscle to do it, but it does it. So let's see if we can get that inner fender material in here and get it through the slip roller and see if we can get that to turn into a cylindrical piece that'll match tires so we can get the inner fenders in snail mail. So been a while since I worked on snail mail. The goal is to get it back over here now that the Chevelle and the Freightliner are running. and get back to work on that. So let's give it a whirl. I have no idea what I'm doing. Let's figure it out. All right, so the instructions are terrible on this. And I couldn't figure out for the longest time what the hell these bars did. And the exploded diagram shows them. Let's see if we can, we'll open up the manual here. Oh, the explode butt diagram shows them there, and they look to be that they go somewhere in this bar here that has this V-piece bolted on it. So there's three holes there. We bolted it into the lower hole, and this piece bolts onto the bottom of it. And what this piece is basically a, I got it tightened down, hold on. This is your stop. Or this is at least what I've gathered. I don't know if this is accurate or not because the instructions are just god-awful terrible. But this is your stop. So you'll put a piece of metal in there and you'll bolt that down where it needs to go. And one thing we noticed when we were cutting these for the first time is this side is right on the arrow, right where it needs to be. But as we went down, it actually drew the metal in and ended up cutting off about 3/8 to a quarter inch more than it needed. And that was before we installed this. So I'm pretty sure that if we had that set up perfectly and that was a stop, that would keep that from happening. That would keep the metal from rolling in and being drawn into the brake. It's not gonna matter for these. These are gonna be a really rough cut to start, but I'm pretty sure that's gonna help that situation. So for the next time, we're gonna, next piece we cut anyway, we're gonna try that with that and see how it works. So let's get the slip roller going. All right guys, so this is my first experience with the slip roller at all. And just noticing things off the bat, this thing will do a tapered or an angled roll, so it'll make like a cone. So this side will be a tighter roll than that side. And I don't want that. I want this thing to be perfectly smooth and roll up. But if you look, let's see if I can get this down on the right level. If you look at the gap that's on that side there between the upper and this side over here, it gets quite a bit tighter. So I think our first order of business is going to be to try to get those leveled out. So, like I said, this is my first time really messing with this, especially on a big piece of sheet metal. I just did a little tiny piece just to test it out and see if we might have things figured out. That's not safe to walk on. So, again, back here, you can see the gap between the rollers is really, really tight here. And that gap is adjusted by these guys. And I think that is going to be what pushes the piece up and gets it to start rolling. So we'll go ahead and lower this down as far as it'll go so we can get the piece in there. Looks like it's bottomed out there, so that's the beginning of it. And that's bottomed out there. So now we're at zero on the back. And the gap on the front, once you pick up on this and get it to where that stop is pretty damn close. So I think we want to keep that distance the same. And we'll see if we can get the piece of metal in there. We might have to pull that out. I have no idea. All right, let's see if we can get this piece of metal in here. This is 16 gauge, which is the maximum this setup can do. It fits in there nice. So, get eyeball squared up. And then I'm gonna put the same amount of tension on each one of those back ones. Probably just go three to start to take the tension off. I didn't feel like that put a lot on it. I'm not doing three full circles, I'm just doing like three quarter turns. see if it will roll. It will roll. There's not a lot of tension on it. Looks like it's feeding straight, so that's good. Let's go ahead and put two more. Yeah, another like a third turns maybe. Alright, so I noticed something here right off the bat. This thing's pretty square.
Is that this roller is not touching at all. It's just on this back guide roller. So I think our first order of business is going to be to turn that up till it touches the metal. We are learning this as we go because I have no idea. I've never used one of these. But that makes sense that once we get it to where it touches the metal. All right, I can hear it touching the metal now. Now I think we're at point zero. So now we can start maybe bending metal,
radiusing metal. See if that'll get it to grab that wheel. Okay. Time out.
All right, so problem number one right off the bat. We took this top roller out. I believe that top roller should mesh with this so that it all works together. It's spring loaded. This little guy was wedged off to the side there. And so that's what was keeping this thing from going down all the way so that the gears would mesh and then be able to feed it through. So let's put this top roller back in and see if that works. That thing is a heavy pig, so just be prepared when you pull that thing out that it's gonna book. It weighs probably.
It weighs every bit of 75 pounds. And then I locked that thing off, so. It is a heavy, heavy little thing. All right. So don't get your fingers caught in there when you set that thing down. All right, that is much better. Now,
it makes a lot more sense. Now the gears are meshing over here. So when we roll this, it rolls that. So that's the problem for the first step. So let's go ahead and get that tightened back down.
Back roll, or we're gonna get it to touch.
Up there.
go ahead and roll it through like this, and we'll see if we start putting any shape in the metal. I don't know if it's tight enough or not to put any shape in it.
They're not meshing on the gear enough.
That's all the way tight on that.
Okay.
Okay, where?
There.
Tighten it. I'm gonna tighten three little wrist turns and see what happens. You can see it
deforming the metal a little bit down in there, so let's see if that'll put a little shape in it. Again, I don't know what I'm doing.
Just put a real little bit of curve in it. I think this is going to take a little while to do. So, make sure it's still tracking straight. It don't move, so that's going to be as straight as it gets. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and cut the time lapse while we get this thing moving, and we'll see if we can make a circle out of it. Alright, well, I definitely got too aggressive on the pinches. I was doing 4 and 5, and I think that was a little aggressive for that last one. And I kind of made a lot tighter of a circle than I wanted to. So I don't think that's going to match a tire too well. I don't know if it'll spring out, or if I have to go cut another one and do it all over again. But this is a learning process. You waste a little bit of money and a little bit of time doing this, but we'll see if we can flatten it out. Yeah, surprisingly stiff. I'm impressed with how stiff this is. I think we can salvage it. The tire pretty closely, so it doesn't have to be perfect. Definitely put some good shape into that. All right, so I had an idea. What would keep you from running this thing in backwards if you got a little too aggressive with the bend and try to straighten it out a little bit? I don't know if this would work or not, but we're just doing some science here, so let's see if we can put it in this one. All right, well, I don't know where the GoPro lost me. We're on the second GoPro now, but you can take the bend out. It's still a little more aggressive on this side than it is this side now. I think we could probably work this area just a little bit more, just from here to here. Put a couple, yeah, maybe just this whole area. Just roll that a little bit more, and I think we can tighten that up. And then we'll, then we got flat back out a little bit. I think this arch is pretty close. I just need to pull this around, so I'm gonna stick it back in the machine here. Just a little bit. We'll put tension on this. I'm probably gonna put two turns on each side. I'm gonna go back and forth on that area and see. We go right up to that line where we need to tighten it a little bit and see if we can tighten that curve up. And I can already see that it's helping. This to be as tight as possible when it's all the way aired out. And then when it's aired up, it'll gain me quite a bit of room for the tire to turn. So it won't be turning the tires when it's aired out. So I think that's where we're gonna go. We'll probably put like a couple chunks of 1 inch or something in there so we have a little bit of room so it's not rubbing. But that fits the tire. Pretty damn splendid. And we're gonna get that radius and hit this part of the tire perfectly. So if this is a little straighter, that's fine. There's plenty of room up there for everything to go. Cool.
Oh, and another thing you want to be careful of is when you're using this, if this isn't tight, this is a, hold on, I don't want to let go of it. So that's the nut that allows your handle to move so you can get more leverage on it. You want to make sure that's good and snug, because if it's not, what ends up happening is this thing will turn and it'll slam down here and it'll break your plastic handle. So that kind of sucks, but what's probably going to end up happening is that's going to just get broke off there, and it is what it is.
I don't know what I'm doing first time using it. If you guys got any tips and tricks, if you used one of these before, go ahead and let me know. I did make a major mistake here. I left the instructions on the bench like that and rolled them over, and they are now cut in half. So throw those away, or they belong in the garbage can.
All right, guys, that's going to be a wrap for the overview on the KAKA Industrial's 3-in-1 roller machine, press brake, and shear. It'll do up to 16 gauge sheet metal. I've been using this thing for the last couple months, kind of on and off, working on Snail Mail's floor pans and wheel wells. I pretty much got rid of the stop on the back because it just kept poking holes in my drywall, and now basically what I'll do is I'll clamp the metal down into the or onto the base plate. I got a C-clamp over there and some vice grips there. Just clamp the sheet metal down in there when I'm cutting it, that way it doesn't drag it through. And then I don't have to worry about adjusting anything in the backside, and also I don't have to worry about poking holes in the drywall, because that really sucks every time I'm trying to move this thing around to get it pushed back into place in the right spot. Kink, get a little aggressive and poke a hole in the drywall. So all in all,
This thing has been a super handy tool to have. You start finding things that you can do with it. I mean, I was bending stuff for the go-kart and other things and just random stuff. I built a shelf in the trailer. You just start finding things that you can bend metal for and make things out of. So it's really cool. Once you have a tool, just start using it and get out there and start making stuff. So I will have a link, Amazon link to this thing in the description. So if you're interested in one of these, go ahead and check it out. We do get some affiliate bucks. That helps us out, helps support the channel. So don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Check out FTPSpeedShop.com and we'll catch you on the next one. Later.